What is up, everybody? It is day four of Wild Eye Week, and I'm going to be reviewing the 2020 releasing of Amityville Island. We're going to need a bigger gun, but we're not going to need a bigger boat. First God's sakes, get out of the water. Good stuff, right? So there's your back. This film is approximately 71 minutes. When you first look at this, you think, hey, is that a creature feature? Are we going to be getting Jaws type film? What are we going to be getting with this film? Well, you really don't get, you know, the creature feature, and you really don't get a Jaws similarity type film with this. You get something completely different. You have a girl who's moving into a house with her four kids, and she stops by this garage sale. And it was a woman who was a real estate agent for the old Amityville house. And the woman is kind of down on her luck, wants to buy everything she has, which is all the items from the house. And the items from the house just happen to be possessed or linked to the Amityville horrors. So after the woman buys all the items at the garage sale, the real estate agent that's selling the stuff ends up dying. The woman that buys the stuff ends up killing all four of her kids, so she goes to jail, prison. While she's in prison, she and this other inmate, I guess because of population reasons, are being pulled. And the reason that they're being pulled is because, one, they want to be mistreated by the warden and some of the people at the jail. And they're asking them to do a fight. Kind of like Fight Club, right? But inside of the jail. And the loser gets to go off the island, basically. Gets to leave the jail. And so they have this fight. And I guess the warden of the jail decides to say, you know what? Fuck it. Let's get rid of both of you guys. But not just throw them out of the jail. He has them sent to an island where they're going to be experimented on by this doctor who is trying to recreate humanity. But he needs to do it with women, of course. So they end up going to this island. And on the island, they're being tested. Their blood's being taken. They are being like lab rats by this doctor. It's a good alternative to prison, so they would think, but it really isn't. So, because they're still treated very badly. And the premise of the film is they've got to find a way to escape the island from the doctors, and because they're being mistreated and they are being experimented on like lab rats. And that is what the film is about. This one was not my cup of tea, but it wasn't terrible either. So, you know, I'm going to give it an average rating. I thought the acting was okay. Visual effects were okay. Some parts of the effects were annoying. For example, in the laboratory, it looked like for some of the noises that is they had a phone turn off, like the alarm, to make it sound like there was a siren going off, and that was really annoying. But oh no, it's not the worst film I've seen, but it's not the best film I've seen. So it's an average rating. One of the things about the women in the prison, one of the features that she has since she was part of the possession, and that she was part of the Amityville situation, and she can take her mind, and she can make animals do stuff to people, like hurt people or kill people. That's really the only reason why the shark is involved, because she can have the shark kill people. She can have bears kill people. I thought that concept was pretty cool. I wish they would have elaborated more on that throughout the film. Some parts of the film were just kind of everywhere. But it's not too bad. It's average. Maybe slightly below average. But go check out Amityville Island. I'm going to keep this one kind of short. And that is day 4. Go check out everybody that's doing these. I'll catch up with you later. This is Hobbs.